Hello, hello, I'm Li Hao. So today we're going to talk about context. So what is context? Well, context is a way for a component to pass data to all its children components, all its child components, all its grandchild, grandchildren in plural, grandchildren, children, any component that is within this parent component will get the data, right? It's a way for you to pass the data to all of them. So if you pass data, from what we learned previously, is you can pass by props. Basically, you have to pass one by one. But context is a way that you can set up and all its children components, all its grandchildren components will receive the data. So to see how we're going to do this, how we're going to use this context, let's take a look at an example that I've prepared for you. So over here, I have app.svelte, which shows a parent component. So this parent component is what we're going to focus on, right? This parent component has a child, one child. And this parent component will shows the child and pass a color called red, right? So now we have a child component which has two grandchild. And to pass the data down, we have to pass this color to grandchild A and grandchild B, because we need the color in both of the components, right? Grandchild A uses the color to change the color of the text, so you see red. Grandchild B uses the color to show the data, right? Show the color as a text. So you can have as many components as you want over here, right? Say I'm gonna have another child 2, which I'm gonna create right now. But let's color, and I'm gonna say child 2 with a color, and maybe add some weird text over here, and we're gonna import child 2. So I'm come over here and say import child 2 from child 2, and I'm gonna use child 2, and also need to pass in the color red, right? Invalid tag name child. Hold on, what is okay? Child 2. Ah, okay, this is okay. So you see the parents. So once okay, let me. I have two color rates over here. Let me just make it nicer. I'm gonna declare a color called red. And as you can see, if I want to pass down the color, I need to do it one. On all my children components, and for each of my children, if it has a grandchildren, I will have to pass it down to each of them as well, so that so you can see over here, let me adjust this. You can see over here a parent has two children, child and child 2, and two grandchildren, grandchild 1, a grandchild A, grandchild B, and you can see we have to pass the color down layer by layer to each of the components. So an alternate of doing this is to use GetContext. And let's take a look at how we can use GetContext to do this instead of having to pass down color level by level. So first thing first is I'm going to import GetContext from Svelte, and I am going to set context. So the parent will set the context, and all the child or grandchildren that needs this value will use get context to get it from them. So I'm going to call set context, and I'm going to pass in two parameters. So set context takes in the first thing is a key, and second thing is the value. So you can actually pass in any, you can have multiple contexts for one component. And it depends on the key of what value you want to pass in, right? So when you call get context in the child, you will get context with the same key so that you can get the same key of the context, right? So over here, since we're going to pass colors, we're going to name it color as the key of the context, and the value of it would be the color rate, right? So I don't have to do this anymore. I don't have to pass color to all my child, right? So let's see, child I don't really need color over here as well, so gonna remove this, and I'm gonna pass it to grandchild A, because you get it from the context. For child 2, we actually need color, right? So the way we get it is we're gonna say import GetContext from Svelte, and we're gonna get context. I'm gonna take it in the same key. So the parent use color, so I'm gonna use the same key over here. So they will return me the color, so I can use the color right now, right? So you can see it's updated to color to red. So internally, context is like a map, and this is the key to the map, which means you can pass in anything that you can pass as a key to a map, right? So if you worry about getting conflicts, then probably you can create an object, right? And pass and use that object. For example, I can come over here and say a context, and I can create a key. So this is an object that you created, and you can import this and use this key in your context, right? So because the data itself is the key itself is by reference, because it's a map, it depends on the reference of the key, then you can instead of worry that maybe, you know, what if someone else have this context name color, will I get conflict? And this way you kind of can ensure that this key will always be unique, right? Because this because unless you get a hold of the reference of this object, you'll never create an object that has the same reference as this key over here. So I can actually come over here and do this instead. Right, now you see it's not available, but I can come over here and import key from context and replace this. Can see now I can read it out again, right? Setting with the same key, and this key is an object reference, and I'm gonna get it from there. So I can, and as long as I ensure that the key reference is unique, then I can make sure basically, I'm sure that I don't get conflicts with naming keys with your context, right? So let's finish this. Let's come over here, grandchild A, and you know, import get from the context. So actually, I can copy these two lines, these few lines, which is to get context, import get context from Svelte, and then import the key, and then I use get context with the key to get the color, right? Let me copy this over for grandchild B as well. Replace this. You can see now grandchild B is also get the value red. Right, so all the children components, grandchildren components will get the same value from the context. Right now I'm gonna create another component called a parent2.svelte. And in this parent2 component, I'm actually gonna import just a grandchild A from grandchild, and I'm gonna show you why in a moment. But I'm gonna come over here and do this, and I am gonna import parent2 in the apt.svelte. So grandchild A, okay, so the grandchild A actually gets context and from the parent and use it as a color for the text, right? So the context over here for parent, this parent, is that the context value of this key is, the value for this context is red, right? So all grandchild A gets the value called red and then set the color as red. But the grandchild A in this parent2 receives nothing in the context. So most likely what you see if you try to console out the color you'll see that one is red and one is undefined because you didn't define the context within this for this component grandchild A, right? This grandchild A lives within parents 2 and lives within which lives within app, and app does not set any context. Parent 2 does not set any context, so it does not get any value from the context. So we can actually come over here and set it up. So we're gonna say import set context from Svelte. I'm gonna say set context. Okay, I need a key, so I'm gonna import the key as well. Import key from context key, and I'm gonna say blue. Right, as soon as I do this, you can see this grandchild A, which is in parent 2, which sets up the context, which value is blue, and then now I get it, and I can't, I style it as blue color, right? So depends on where grandchild A is located, whether it's within the context of the parent, the first parent, then you get color red. If it's in the parent 2, you get color blue. And context itself can't override each other. So say for example, in this example, we see that parent creates a context, right? Which is color red. And now I have child, which I have grandchild A and grandchild B. Right, let's also import grandchild A. In the child 2, I'm going to use it over here. So this is still within the context of the parent, which has the color red, right? But what if in the child 2, I'm going to set a new context here. I'm going to import this. Okay, I'm going to set a new context with the same key, right? So although this grandchild, this child 2 receives a context from the parent, which is the red color, but from this child 2 on below, it will set a new context for all the children and grandchildren. And this context is going to have a value called green. Right, as soon as you do this, right, let's right, it does not matter the order, but as soon as you do this, you can see that, actually the order matters. Okay, as soon as you do this, you see that everything below color is going to be green, right? Grandchild A is green, although it's within parent B, the first parent, right? It sets red, but then parent inside have a child 2. Child 2 sets a context called green, which overrides it, right? So how do you think about this is actually you try to, it matters on where grandchild A is being created. So it looks up to the parents, right? So the parent has one child 2. Child 2 has context, then you will use that one, right? If it does not, you go up again one level and see parents has context, yes, and then you use the parent one, right? So as soon as it finds the value, then it will be overridden, right? And apparently the order of set context and get context matter, right? So I think in terms of implementation, it's a very simple map, right? So if you set the value first for this context, then any time later on when you try to get context from this mapping, it's actually being overridden, right? So now you get context is the value called green rather than red. But if you get first and then you set it later on, then you get this still gets the one from the parent, which is red, and then this will override it and become green, right? But this will only override for all its children, right? It does not matter if you come over here and say grandchild, sorry, I think it should be come over here, and you know the order of child 1 or 2, it does not matter, right? Because this will only override for itself and it's all its children, right? So whether it's sibling, it's whether the siblings, whether you override the context first for yourself, and then you know whether does it affect a sibling. Well, it does not. So here you go, having a context where you set up a way to pass data to all your children and grandchildren, right? There's a few rules on how you use this, Basically, first is that setContext and getContext has to be called during component initialization, meaning right here, right? You can't call it later on. For example, setTimeout. You can't do it like this, right? So this is similar to a component lifecycle methods. You can't call it outside component initialization because this function itself needs to know what is the component that is initializing right now and then set the context to that component. So you can't do it inside setTimeout. Same thing goes with getContext, right? So that is rule number one. And rule number two is that it's not really a rule, but it's if you take a look at here, getContext, this function will be only called during initialization, meaning this value will only be read out during initializing this component, right? Meaning, if this value is like a state where you change it dynamically, it won't reflect over here, right? This you reads up once, so it won't change later on if you change the value or the variable in the parent. And we're going to take a look at how you can have communication, like updating values in the next video. So if you have any questions for now, feel free to comment down below. And if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. And as always, remember to subscribe to my channel so that you get notified when the next one is out. So see ya, bye bye.